So if you're using PowerPoint for your visual aids, here's what you're going to want to do. Open up PowerPoint and select a blank presentation. And it's going to open a page that looks like this. The first thing that you want to do is go to Layout and Blank to take away all of the text boxes because you just really want the slides that you're going to be putting the pictures on. Then you're going to right-click on the thumbnail here and format its background. Come over here and change the color of the background to black, and go ahead and apply that to all of the slides. Then you're going to want to duplicate this slide so that you have all of the black slides. There's a reason that you want all of the black slides, and it's just because it makes it look a lot cleaner. And I'll show you what it looks like without the black slide momentarily. But it's important to know that for your visual aids, you only need 2 to 3 visual aids, give or take. You don't want a ton more than that because then it just becomes a distraction and you can't really let the visual aids have the amount of time that they need. But you also don't want fewer than that because you need to make sure that your audience fully understands your speech. I'm going to show you how to build a presentation with 2 visual aids. So I have all of these slides. Oops, I only need 5. And you're going to need 5 slides because you're going to have a blank slide, a picture slide, a blank slide, a picture slide, and a blank slide. So I'm going to go to Google and I'm going to go to specifically to Google Images. And let's say that I'm doing my speech on puppies. And I get all these adorable pictures of puppies. Look at them, they're so cute. Okay, so I have to pick the cutest puppies. I'm going to go with this one because he's adorable. And I'm going to go ahead and right click on the image and save the image as. And I'm just going to go ahead and save that to my desktop. Google has taken away the option where you can download it from the website. So in order to get the full size, you do need to go ahead and download it the way that I just showed you. The other picture I'm going to use is this one because it's a corgi and I love corgis. So I'm going to save that image as well. And I'm going to save that to my desktop. So now, when I have my presentation, whoops, that's not what I wanted. If I sneak a peek, oh, there's my 2 puppy pictures. So I'm going to go ahead and just drag this onto my slide, just like this. And there's my puppy. And I'm going to drag the other picture. Oh no, that one didn't work. Oh, I have to pick another picture. Okay. Let's see here. That's our syllabus. How about this group of pip puppies? That one seems like a good idea. Save image as. There we go. Its name is appropriately. Aww. So there's my picture. And so now, when I launch it into a slideshow, by either clicking down here on this slideshow button, by clicking here and going to slideshow play from start, or by clicking on, there was another button, but it disappeared. So one of those 2 options, play from start or down here. I like the down here button. And now you have your presentation slides. You can see that it starts off with a black slide so that you can give your introduction and you can talk all about how cute puppies are, and then you can show an example of a cute puppy. And you tell us how big its ears are and how cute its little nose is, and then when you're done talking about the puppy, you move on to the next black slide. You hit the next button. And then the puppy is out of sight when you don't need to be talking about it. And then you bring up the next idea of a group of adorable puppies. Oh, aren't they so cute? So you bring this picture up when you want to talk about litters of puppies, maybe. And then you go to your last slide, which is also black. That way, whenever your audience doesn't need to be looking at your visual aid, it doesn't exist for your audience. Now, I told you earlier that it was important to have black slides, and this is why. I'm just going to show you what it looks like if I format the background on this slide again, and I have a white background instead of a black one. So now I start off on my black slide, and when I put this picture up, you can see that it has the white bars on either side, whereas it's surrounded by black otherwise. And then I go to the black screen, And this one looks much cleaner than this one does. So having those black slides is actually really key to looking super professional. Now, the last thing of note when it comes to these pictures is that you can't just drag the picture, this thumbnail, onto your desktop and expect that it's going to look okay. I'm going to show you what that looks like just for the purposes of demonstration. So if I try to just save this, and it's not even letting me do it. So if you try to save a picture just straight from here, it's going to end up looking really pixelated. So in addition, you want to make sure that you're looking at the picture and making sure that it's big enough. You can see this one, for example, has 1280 by 1016 pixels, whereas this one has only 512 by 512. So if I take this picture and I save the image to my desktop and then go ahead and put it into my PowerPoint. Whoops, there we go. You can see how much smaller it is just when I drag it onto the PowerPoint itself. These ones ended up being the right size when I put it on there. It filled the screen, it filled the slide, but this one didn't. And so when I launch it, if I leave it just like this, it's going to look like this, which looks really weird compared to this big one. So you're going to want to take it and drag it to make it bigger. And when you do that, however, it can oftentimes come out pixelated. So you have to be really careful when you are adding pictures like this that are too small. You always want to make sure that they're big enough.